Okay, so I know that a lot of people know me mostly from my Shadow Priest videos, and I kind of figured it would be helpful to sort of list off some things about me, I guess, to try to get to know me better than just, for the most part, I was like kind of no face behind the gameplay that I posted, so I'll try to think of as many relevant things that I can come up with, or any random facts that might be interesting. Not super random, but kind of general for now. And if there are other things that people might want to know, then I would gladly make another video addressing those. So, first off, I am 26 years old. My birthday was recent, so I just turned 26. I have one older brother who lives in New York. He works in finance. My parents currently still reside in New Jersey, and I was born and raised in New Jersey for my entire life until I moved to San Diego in April of 2017. Just in case people are not aware, I have three pets. This one is Milo. He is my third child. He was born on October 14th, 2016, and I brought him home in December. So he is my last baby and my biggest annoyance. Sammy is taking a shit right now, but I brought him home first. He was my very first pet. I wanted a cat first because they are very low maintenance, which make them great pets. He was a great cat, but he does some very weird behaviors right now that can be annoying. He came home with me January 2014, so this was very shortly after I first moved out on my own. I moved out December 2013, and I graduated from college from Rutgers University with a Bachelor of Science in Computer Science in May of 2013. Sorry about that random segue into my education there, but yes, Sammy was my first. I adopted him. Milo is a ragdoll, purebred cat that I purchased through a breeder. And then Ryla, right now, she is crated because I just got home for lunch and I wanted to record this really quick while I had natural daylight. But Ryla was purchased from a breeder in Somerset, Pennsylvania, from Lauderdale's Siberians. She was purchased as a pet for a price of $800, in case people are wondering. Milo was like $675, I believe. I think Milo was kind of surprisingly cheaper than some of the other ragdoll prices that I've seen around, and I think Milo's pretty cute, so I think I lucked out. But Riley's birthday is January 5th of 2016, all these dates that I have to remember. And I first brought her home in April, so she was January 5th, February, March. Okay, so yeah, she was like roughly 3 months when I brought her home. I actually purchased a motorcycle in 2011. The reason that I first got interested in it when I had initially no interest whatsoever was because the parking situation at Rutgers University was terrible. Basically, you would park at a lot and take the bus around the campus, and I hated it because I hate any form of public transportation where you have to wait for the bus to arrive. So I had a class with a female friend at the time who had just gotten a new Honda CBR250. So she would ride me back to my car, and I was sitting in the back passenger. And I guess, like, just talking with her more and doing that, I really enjoyed the feeling of just riding on a motorcycle. So she helped me go see a motorcycle in like northern New Jersey that was on Craigslist. It was a used Kawasaki Ninja 250, model year 2007. So I purchased it for $2,000. And they were very kind enough to bring it to my house, which was like about over an hour drive because it was far and I didn't have a truck or anything to bring it back, so they were nice enough to do it for me. I mean, I sold my bike in spring of 2016. I think that when I first got Rylai, I wasn't sure that I would have much time to ride anymore, and I was also feeling that I was not as passionate about riding to risk my life to die on the road from another driver's error, which is the cause of a lot of motorcycle accidents, and I feel like the punishment that they get is not high enough. Like, I just see articles about, a woman texting and then killing a motorist, and she doesn't, I don't think she gets much of a penalty for that. So, even though I sold it, and for a while I was thinking I wouldn't ride again, now that I'm here in San Diego, I am very eager to ride again. And one of the things that I desire is to move out in the middle of nowhere. Not necessarily in the middle of nowhere, but I want more land and I want more space between me and my neighbor. Basically, when I go outside, I don't want to see other people unless I travel to a place where people will be, like a grocery store. I would like for that to be like where I own a home someday. Just seeing like a lot of land in all directions when I step out of my house is kind of what I'm hoping for. But if I have that, or eventually try to obtain that, I feel like riding would be a good opportunity for me again, because in those places you won't come across that many other cars. So having less traffic around that area would make it so that accidents are less likely. So there are also a ton of benefits to riding, like parking is easier. You can also lane split here in California, so it would make traffic less of an issue. But just situationally, traffic might be something that I don't even worry about depending on what my situation is in the future. But just overall, I do miss riding, and when I go hiking, I drive west. Just kidding, I drive east an hour. So if I had a bike and I just rode to where I hike, there's a mountain and it's just so beautiful. I feel like I would enjoy it so much if I was able to ride out east. So that's just a lot of what I would love to do if I was able to ride. The feeling of riding a motorcycle is so much different than a car. It's exhilarating. You just feel like you're connected with the outside world because you're not encaged in something. It's just great. So one small fact turned into a story, but oh, height-wise, I am 5'3". I'm very short. My mom is shorter than me. My dad is, I think he's like 5'5" or 5'6", and my brother is somewhere around that range. We're not a very tall family. I mostly only talk to my immediate family. My extended family is in Taiwan. My dad has some family in New York that I guess is related to me in more extensions, or however the hell that stuff works, but I am not close with my extended family whatsoever. Random fact, I drive a Toyota Prius. I actually recently paid it off, so I'm very happy about that. I bought it in October of 2012, and it's a year 2012 model. It's actually a great car. I know people hate the way it looks and such, but I guess depending on what you're looking for, I feel like nowadays I am trying to prioritize like function and usefulness over appearance and just having fancy stuff. So, cars for me, even though I love, recognizing cars on the road, I like Teslas. I see Maseratis driving around here from time to time, and they look awesome, and I think they're great. I mean, obviously, depending on my situation, if I just lived a comfortable lifestyle and had a pretty decent paying job, I would not splurge on a car. I think the fact that my car has great mileage is a huge benefit to me. I love that. I tend to drive for a week. It really depends on where I go and how often I go out, but if I were good, I could probably go a week and a half on a full fill up, and then it would cost me roughly $25 to fill up my entire tank. And that's California prices. I don't remember what they are, so I can't say for sure, but it's very maneuverable. It's a small car, it's very easy to drive, so it's great for me. And I'm really hoping that I can drive this car for a long time. I guess the main issue is that, yeah, it can feel kind of small. Since I have a crate in the car for Riley, I have to have the back seats down. So right now I only have space for one person in my car. I mean, I guess technically I can have one other seat in the back up, but since I pretty much never remove that crate from my car, the back seats are always down. So I won't be able to bring a lot of people, but I don't think I've had many people in my car in its entire lifespan, so I don't think that will be an issue. Oh yeah, I was going to talk about my computer and the specs that I have in it. Maybe I should just do a separate video on that, describing kind of like my life cycle of what I've used throughout the years, in case people are curious. But right now, my computer that I built, I think it was November 2015. I've been using it since then and it's worked fine. I don't really see myself upgrading for quite a while, especially if I don't play anything lately. I feel like with the specs that I have right now, it's overkill for what I play, but I just wanted to have a powerful computer just cause. And even though I'm not really using its full capabilities right now, I still think it's going to last me for a pretty long time. Oh, I guess another important thing would be to know what I do now for work. I work as a software engineer. Right out of college, I started off first as a quality assurance analyst, which is pretty much testing. And then after that, I was an application developer. And then the first job that I got out here is software engineer. And I think that's pretty much kind of what I want to continue to do. I'm not really sure if I want to do management or not. I don't feel like I'll do very well managing people, but who knows what's gonna happen with that. My first start into playing games was, I think it was a big influence from my brother. He was always the one in the beginning who asked my parents if we could buy consoles. So we started off with Nintendo 64. Hey. Stop it. So in the beginning, yeah, can't see. In the beginning, my brother wanted the Nintendo 64. So that was our very first introduction to games and consoles. We played Banjo-Kazooie, Perfect Dark, GoldenEye, and Super Smash Bros. Melee. And I'm sure there was like a Mario Party thrown in there, but those were a lot of fun. Specifically Super Smash Bros. Melee. Our first venture into PC gaming, I forget the very first game we played, but we played old school stuff like Age of Empires and Command & Conquer, like Tiberian Sun, stuff like that. I think our first introduction to Blizzard games was StarCraft. For me, mainly Brood War was my first introduction, and then from there From there I went to Diablo 2, and then I went from Diablo 2, which was my favorite game of all time at that age. I pretty much copied the installation discs and the play discs a bunch of times just to make sure I would never lose the ability to play that game or install it on my machine. I guess it was like not very long after that I started playing World of Warcraft. I think I got into the game very late. I was map hacking in Diablo 2 because I was farming Mephisto with my sorceress, and finding that level 3 was so annoying, so I map hacked and my account was banned. So after that, I needed another game, so I went searching and I found World of Warcraft. I really wish I found it sooner because then I would have more time to spend on it. At the time, it was really awesome. I didn't have any real life friends to play with, so I pretty much just played it by myself. I started off with a hunter, and then eventually in Burning Crusade, I made the priest, which is where Alessandra was born, and then she was my main for the rest of eternity. Yeah, I'd say for now that's pretty much all I have. As a goodbye, I will present to you Milo. He's always whining. All right, goodbye.